Welcome to the Drupal tutorial series on the RESTful Web Services in a Drupal. In the last video, we have seen how to configure the modules which are required to enable the REST services in the Drupal. So for that, click on configuration and after that click on the REST link which is below the web services. So on this page, we will now enable the content REST API. Using that API, we will update that content using the patch method and delete the content. And if you want to create the node, we need to use the post method. So first we will enable this by clicking on the enable button. We will keep the all setting as it is. Methods are get, post, delete, patch, accepted request format equal to JSON, authentication provider as a basic auth. Save the configuration. In this tutorial, I will show you how to get the node data using the RESTful web services. So we will use the this service slash node and the ID of the node. So to check the APIs, go to the postman. I have created this postman collection. I will share this collection after completing this series. First, we need to enter the website URL. So our website URL is localhost slash Drupal. So paste it here and select the method as a get, because we are using this get method to get the node data using the RESTful API. And after that, we need to pass this node slash node ID. So I will fetch the data of the first node. So I add the ID of node as a 1, and in the parents we need to pass the format underscore format equal to JSON and click on send to send the request. So here you can see we are getting these details of the nodes, like the node ID as a 1, this UID, version ID, language code, type of that node. So target ID is type is article, revision timestamp, again the title. So I will show you that node. So in the content, and the ID of this node is 1. Title of the node is the welcome to the Drupal Academy, and same we are getting here as a title. After that, we are getting this created date, change date, and you can see the in the body we are getting this lorem ipsum content which I have added. Say now I will create the one more node, content, add content. We'll add the content in the article content type. In the title, we will add the title as a get REST API REST article, and in the body, we will add the body. Click on save to save this node. The node ID of this node is a 5. Now we will add the ID as a 5 in our API. Click on send to send the request. In the response, you can see we will check the title. Title is the get REST API test article, and in the body, get REST API test article body. Right now, this node data is publicly available to the anonymous user. So I will show you that if I access this node by using the anonymous user. In this window, I have logged in as an admin user, and in the next window, I am logged in as an anonymous user. Still, this data is available. So suppose this data is important and you don't want to share it publicly, and you want to share those data only to the authenticated users. So for that, how can we restrict that data? So first we need to change the permission. For that, click on the people, click on permission and search for the published content. So here you can see right now the view published content is accessible to the everyone, like anonymous user, authenticated user, content editor. Now I will remove this permission for the accessing this content by the anonymous users. Click on save and now we will hit this API again. Click on send. So here you can see that we are getting the message like no authentication credential provided. Means this data or this API only be accessible to the authenticated users. So to set the authentication, we need to add the basic authentication for this API. From this drop down, select the basic auth and in the user pass the username. So my username is admin user and in the password is admin at the rate 123456. And now you can see in the headers the basic authorization is added and our credentials are encoded using the base 64. Now we will again hit this API. So here we are getting the response from the API for the authenticated users. Now this API is accessible to the all authenticated users. Suppose you have the multiple vendors, you want to share that data with the different vendors. So for that we can create the multiple roles and assign the permissions. So I will show you that as well. So first create the one role as a client one, add role, client one, click on save. Now create the user with the client one role, add user abc client one, password admin. Assign the role as a client one and create the new account. Go to the permission, search for the publish content permission, view publish content. So now we will assign the view access to only the client one so that node will be only accessible to the client one and the administrator, not to the other users. So save this configuration. If for now I try to access that API using the another role or the authenticated user, it should show the access not allowed error. So here we can see the access content permission is required. Now we will change the user to abc client one, which has the role as a client one, and send the request. So here you can see now this node is only accessible to the client one, and in this way you can create the multiple roles and the users, and you can distribute your APIs. That's it from this tutorial. In the next tutorial we will see how to update the node content using the patch method. So I hope this tutorial is helpful for you. Please like the video and subscribe the channel for the more Drupal related content. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.